Manjusha Singh. I'm from Pratap Academy, Chhattisgarh. I'm a British Council certified trainer for IELTS. Today we will learn about IELTS, what exactly IELTS is. So as you can see on the board, it's abbreviation of International English Language Testing System. This test is one of the English language proficiency tests around the world. Even you must be knowing about the other tests, like there are TOEFL and PTE. But this is the only test which is widely recognized for three purposes: study visa, work permit or immigration. And most of the countries accept it. The countries where people usually go are this, like US, UK, Canada, New Zealand, Australia, Germany and even many more. So this could be a best test for you if you are planning to study abroad and if you want to settle abroad. Now let's get into more details of this. There are basically two modules in IELTS. One is we call as academic module. One is the general training module. Even we have another module, like it's called as UKV IELTS, but it is a secured test mainly for UK visas. If you want to go to UK for some purpose, then you need to get detail about this particular type of exam. Today we will be talking more about academic and the general training. Now, who should give academic and who should give the general training? If you are planning to study abroad, then you should take the academic module. And if you want to go abroad for permanent residence or work permit, then general training is for you. There are some similarities as well as differences in both the modules. Now let us see who conducts this exam. There are three bodies who jointly manage this exam. One is the British Council. This is based in UK. Second is the International Development Programme, it is based in Australia. The third body is Cambridge ESOL Examination, it is also based in UK. And the thing is, these two centres, IDB and British Council, they conduct the exam worldwide, while Cambridge sets the paper. Now the next is, when this exam is conducted? This exam is conducted throughout the year in all the countries. For 48 times for the academic students and 20 up to 24 times for the general training students. You can choose the day of your exam, the place of your exam. The thing that you only need is your valid passport to book your exam as well as to present it as a proof of your identity. We have 80 plus centers in our country where you can choose from and you can give your exam. Now, this exam is available in both the versions, online as well as offline version. You can choose which one is suitable to you. Okay? Now, let us talk about the other things, like results. You know, every exam has got results. But in IELTS, we don't get marks, we get bands. We get bands from 1 to 9. Each band has got a meaning, an interpretation for it. Like, 9 means the excellent user, the one who has a great command over English language. And that goes on decreasing. And the bands are awarded in whole and half form, like 6, 6.5, 7, 7.5, likewise. Okay. Now the exam is very costly. In India, this exam costs, as on date, 12,650 rupees. So you must be well prepared before giving the exam. The scorecard validity is 2 years. Your scorecard will stay valid for 2 years, so you don't need to worry, you don't need to rush for your application. As I told you earlier, you need a valid passport to book your exam as well as to give it as an identity proof. There is no negative marking anywhere in the exam. I'm telling this specially because half of the exam is objective, half is subjective. So there is no penalty for wrong answers. You can write all the answers without worrying about the penalty. Now, the exam duration. This exam is conducted for 2 hours 40 minutes. Listening, reading, writing. Speaking test is done on a different day and for this 11 to 14 minutes are required. So, just now we discussed some listening, reading, writing and speaking. Let's go in detail. These are the main components of any English language exam. Listening, reading, writing and speaking. These are the 4 pillars of communication actually. Listening and reading are the test of our receptive skills. And writing and speaking, they are the test of our expressive skills. Obviously, for any non-native English speakers, be difficult and receptive skills will be easier. In each of this component, you will be awarded one band out of 1 to 9, whole and half, for each of them. And the final scores are the average of all these four components. I hope these things are very much clear to you, and we will get into IELTS in detail more. Just keep watching our next video. Thank you.